but he hasn't carried a full load but once this year. As for the Steelers, James Conner put the ball on the ground last week. Steelers head coach Mike Tomlin told him that's a vulnerability teams will look to expose. But when I talked to Conner, he said he's not concerned. He said, I know that that's not who I am. It was just one incident of poor ball security. And truly, for the Steelers, the bigger issue might be having a commitment to the run. It's something they haven't shown these last few weeks.
Ooh, Mike Rapp loves that.
Just read my notes.
Well,
thank you.
The other side of this, the other running backs in this game, the good news here for the Chargers, Austin Eckler is actually averaging more yards per touch than Melvin Gordon. Although, listen, Eckler has half the touches, so
yeah,
they're going to miss Melvin Gordon, but they do have Eckler there, which is nice. These are two of the top six offenses. So which one do you think has the edge tonight? Who can get it done, Steve?
Well, I'm going to go with Rivers just because the Steelers have not really looked like that team after the Thursday night Panthers 50, that 52-point route. They have not been that same team ever since. And the Los Angeles Chargers keep putting it together. They have guys and technicians that they know their roles. We can't tell which role, which team, which guys on the Steelers are playing each week.
Yeah, I love Didi's report. I'm talking about running the football with James Conner. The Pittsburgh Steelers offense got to understand, to win games, it's about running the football and with their offense. Mm-hmm. Let me read some notes to you guys. Last week, in the loss to Denver, only 75 rushing yards. In the losses this season, they've only averaged 42 rushing yards. In their wins, 109. So that tells you something right there. They need to get this kid the ball even more. And you can control the tempo of a game and help out some of the back-end parts of your defense by getting this kid the ball even more and running the football. We're getting to the part of the season where it's playoff time. It's playoff football. It's the physical brand of football really shows up. You saw them. I feel like the Pittsburgh Steelers get a little too cute sometimes. Mm-hmm. You saw it last week. They did that RPO on the goal line that ended up being an interception. Mm-hmm. Hand the football off. Again, like I said yesterday, this team has not won much just being off of Ben Roethlisberger's arm. Mm. Okay? They need defense and they need run game.
James Conner, though, has to be thinking about those fumbles.
I think so. Like every running back, if you fumble, trust me, the next time you get the ball, you're thinking about it.
You're going,
don't fumble. So I'm sure it's on his mind.
That 52-point outburst, that was their last home game. The last 2 weeks they've been on the road, and this team at home this year offensively has been a completely different story. Where are the numbers? 35.4 points per game. The only egg they laid at home was against Baltimore in that Sunday night earlier in the year, at least offensively, and 23.2 on the road. They're still scoring a decent clip on the road, but they just look so much more comfortable at home. They're back home tonight. I'll take them. There's really no great insight into this one.
No.
Ben Roethlisberger and Antonio Brown early in the season were having trouble finding their stride. They seem to have gotten as the season wore on, particularly in that game against Carolina. I thought, man, these guys are clicking, and they're not going to stop. So I still think that that's a dangerous thing that the Chargers have to account.
Even after Ben called him out a little bit this week?
Yeah, I'm okay with that. I really
not
am.
Not public.
Oh, we're going to talk about that a little later, so bring that right back in.
That's a tease.
Thanks.
That's a tease.
But also, just to get back to your point on Phillip Rivers, he's obviously coming off that game where he threw just one incompletion, and without Melvin Gordon, they're probably going to lean more on Phillip Rivers, and the fact that he's averaging the most yards per attempt right now in his entire career. He's been so good. 9.07. He has 26.
In the whole 75 plays versus.
Not the same flow?
You know, not the same flow.
You're getting that oxygen
mask. Yeah, your lungs are saying, what are we doing here?
Well, Rivers and Roethlisberger, though, they've combined for 412 starts. So we have two established guys in this game. But we want to talk about a guy coming up.